bring out the truth of the Bible and you compare it to the things that are going on today, it should make you grasp to it more and gravitate onto it more. And then to understand that this is your God, good night. What more has to be said? How much more bloodshed? How much more diseases, man? The Lord is trying to protect you. Give him a reason to protect you, man. And he's going to do his fatherly duty and pursue you and show you Exodus 15:3.
Africans, dark skin, are they Jews? Africans, Jews. Africans today, somebody from Nigeria, Cameroon, Ethiopia.
Are they
Jews? Are those Africans
there are
over there?
Of Shem.
You can't
there
answer
are children
that.
Of Abraham in Africa, that. Yes.
So you got love for Africans,
I
but the Spanish and Native Indians, who are our brothers, you don't got no
I
love for them. Because you
are
Uncle Tom Coon, that's why. You are the simple Uncle Tom Christian nigga.
Yes.
You have love for the Africans, but you ain't got love for our
people.
You got love for the Africans. Ain't no goddamn African, no damn Jew. I asked you if the Africans are the 12 tribes of Israel, and you just said yes. You got love for heathens, but you don't got love for black people. You a simple, weak Uncle Tom nigga. I bet you got one of them African wenches in your house. I bet you got some of them African wenches in your house eating jollof rice with that ugly ass that Dafiki. I bet you got one of them Africans in your goddamn bed. I bet you got one of them useless Africans in your bed with a clitoris cut off. With a clitoris cut off. Because you don't have no love for God's people. And you're going to learn the hard way. Just like everybody else.
That's their show up.
Tell them where you at.
But you can't show us nothing. All you can do
Book
is
of Revelation, chapter 11, verse 8. And their dead bodies, the Bible said, and their dead bodies. Who is this referring to? Whose bodies lay dead in America? Whose children are murdered by the police in America? Whose people are murdered? Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And the Bible is prophesying that, man.
You was the same fool last week saying we need guns.
Right.
We need guns.
Absolutely.
We need guns. Well,
yes.
Listen.
They got guns,
what,
you dummy.
What you gonna shoot the coronavirus
guns,
with? What you gonna use to shoot the coronavirus
right.
with?
What
caliber?
Propaganda.
What, 45 ACP?
Coronavirus
9mm, huh?
Nobody
what you gonna use?
No
what you gonna use for the plagues God is bringing? What you going to use to shoot the plagues God is bringing?
Answer the question.
I'm gonna ask you a question. How many Hispanics have died? How many Hispanics
have
died?
Because they have Neanderthal DNA.
How many Hispanics
have died?
How many? So what
blacks
do blacks
don't
got?
Have it.
How many blacks
we don't
got?
Have Neanderthal DNA, dummy.
How many blacks died?
You are
how
dumb.
Many blacks died?
Why y'all got this
how
dummy
many
up
blacks
here?
Died?
He's a cold-blooded
how many
dummy.
Blacks died?
None.
How many Hispanics
zero.
Died? How many Hispanics died? None. How many Native Indians died? You got this face?
Sure. I'm pretty sure
how many Native Indians
I'm pretty
died?
Sure. I'm pretty sure it's false, but I don't know.
You don't know. I'm telling you none.
The Hispanics haven't died?
None.
No Hispanics have died.
What's on
that.
Coronavirus?
That.
How you? Oh wait, how do you know true. Black people have
but
died?
Because you said been true.
How do you know no black people have died from yeah. coronavirus?
The statistics.
The statistics from yeah. what? The news, right?
Right. They would not hide the fact that they're trying to hide
right.
the fact that we not kept it.
No,
they,
but it would come out.
If we died,
it would come out.
Right.
So tell me, has it come out that Hispanics have got it? Has it come out that Native Indians have got it?
I've only been paying attention to my people.
It's not.
I've been only paying attention to my people. Now,
but I understand.
Like
I understand.
You love them Hispanic.
But yes, I do. Yes, I do. Say it again.
Don't they have
say
white
it again. Arms? Say it again. I love them Hispanic.
How did they get Hispanic?
I
white
love them Native
how
Indians.
Did they get
no, let's,
how did they
that's
get
good. But let me ask you something.
Answer that.
How many Africans have died from coronavirus? A lot. A lot.
No, not.
What?
Zero.
Go look right now in North Africa and Ethiopia. They got coronavirus and
right.
died.
Are they black people?
Yes.
No.
Yes, them Africans is dying
no,
from
no,
it.
No, they have not.
How many white people have died?
Zero people have died.
White?
Blacks. Zero blacks have died. And
zero
the only ones that they claim
have died.
It were old.
Hamites are getting it.
Right.
Ethiopians are getting it.
Right.
Chinese are getting it. Japanese are getting it. The Lord is separating the heathen
from
his people.
People
the Lord is separating the heathen from his people.
Disease.
I ain't got to teach you nothing.
From the common
God
code.
Is showing you that blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians are one people through the plague. Now I'm asking you, which gun are you going to shoot the plague with?
That's your evidence?
Which gun are you going to shoot the people, shoot the plague with?
Right.
Which gun? Huh?
Right.
None. You can't fight with God.
Right.
God is bringing plagues to this land, and more plagues are coming, and less of us going dead, and more of them are going to get it. And there's nothing you can do about it. You're going to learn to eat some arroz con pollo. You're going to learn to eat some rice and gandules. You're going to learn to talk that Native Indian language. You're going to learn to respect God's people.
That's right. They put us in
chains. Give a hand, man. Give him a hand, man. We speak from the Bible out here, man. If you think you know the Bible, where's your Bible, man? Anybody that wants to speak to us, man, we speaking from the Bible. If you don't have a Bible up here, that means you're just speaking what you think, man. And that's the problem with our people, man. We all have opinions in the black community when nobody is coming back to the source. And that source is the Bible. Out here, we read from the Bible, man. Regardless of how we feel. And guess what? This book has the solution. This book has the answer. This book tells us who's the devil and who's the children of the Lord. And right here, we're reading the scripture about how the children of the Lord are suffering in a place that is spiritually Egypt. We're suffering in America. We're dying in America. We're not respected in America, man. The Bible talks about it, and we want to come out and teach our feelings, man. We want to preach our feelings. You know what that's like? Imagine, bro, you know I say all the time. Imagine you go to school, and you got 28 students, and you got one teacher. And imagine the teacher gives a test out to all 28 students. And imagine the teacher says, I want y'all to take this test. And after you take the test, I want you to grade your own test. Wouldn't everybody give themselves an A? Wouldn't everybody have a passing grade on the test if they grade the test? You know why? Because in the black community, we all think what we think is right. We all follow what we think is right and what we feel is right. There's only one teacher. There's only one standard. There's only one right. And you can find that in this book right here. The book that everybody's afraid to read. The book that everybody thinks they knows, but nobody actually knows except the men back here, man. And we read from this book, man. Tell me you what.
Verse 8, Revelation chapter 11. And the dead bodies.
And listen, and if you don't have this, when you're talking about the Lord, you got to have the book of the Lord. Talk about the Lord. If you don't have this, we ignore you, man. We ignore you.
You never had one disagreement.
And listen, man.
You never disagree with anything.
He's all bent out of shape over the Hispanics and the Native Indians.
Right.
I ain't about to give him no breakdown of the 12 tribes. But I'm going to give him the breakdown of the plagues.
I'm
going to give them a breakdown on the plagues. For anybody else, Genesis 49, you can come to the school and learn about Ephraim. Ephraim that stays unturned, that can go over the wall. Fruitful is Ephraim. That's what his name. Aparia means thou art fruitful. You will learn about Issachar. And crouching down between two burdens. Love to work. You're going to learn about them. But I'm going to show you how God is showing who his children are.
That's right.
From the plagues in the Bible and the plague going on right now.
That's right.
Read Exodus 11 and 7.
Call out of what God. Exodus chapter 11, verse 7. But against any of the children of Israel shall not a dog move his tongue against man or beast.
You know what this says? This is the plague that went through Egypt.
Right.
A racist plague that only killed Egyptians and did not touch the children of Israel. And God let that plague go through Egypt to make a difference between the children of Israel and every other heathen. Read it from the top again.
Come on, verse 7. But against any of the children of Israel shall not a dog move his tongue.
Go up to verse 6.
Come on. At verse 6. And there shall be a great cry throughout all the land of Egypt.
And America is spiritually Sodom and Egypt.
That's right.
Right now, today, and there's a great cry going through the land of America, just like it did Egypt. I'm not saying the coronavirus is exactly what happened in Egypt, right. But it's one of the many plagues God has put into America, just like he plagued Egypt before the angel of death. Right. And they're crying now. They're crying over their loved ones dying. They're crying over the stock market, right. The economy. They're crying over there in Wuhan. They sound like a bunch of drunk hyenas.
Yep. Woo,
woo, woo, woo, woo, woo, woo. Crying over their babies.
Right.
They're crying. Go ahead.
Such as there was none like it nor shall be like it anymore.
Exactly. What happened in Egypt? They ain't gonna have no recording of that until Christ come back.
That's right.
But what's going on out through the earth is of God.
That's right.
And he is plaguing the earth.
That's
why?
Right.
And let's see why he's plaguing. Go ahead.
Verse 7. But against any of the children of Israel.
Right.
But against any of these 12 tribes, the so-called Negro, the so-called Hispanic,
that's
the
right.
so-called Native Indian.
That's right.
Against any of these 12 tribes, go ahead.
Shall not a dog move his tongue.
Shall not a dog move his tongue.
That's
you
right.
heathens, you're not going to be able to even speak against us in this day.
Damn right.
You're too busy worrying about who's coughing.
Right.
You're too busy worrying about the Wuhan.
Right.
You get the Native Indians whooping cough, now you coughing coronavirus.
That's right.
Against any of the children of Israel shall no dog move his tongue. Go ahead.
Come or come. Against man or beast.
Against man or beast. You can't say a goddamn thing to us
in
this
day. Right.
You can't say a goddamn thing to us in this day. Well, let's see. Well, let's see. Let's see. Read.
That ye may know.
That ye may what?
That ye may know.
You see, he didn't want to listen to the Bible.
Right.
He don't care about the Bible.
Right.
He don't care about God's word. He really just out here to stop the word of God. To love that filthy African you got in the house. Read it again.
That ye may know.
That he may what?
No.
That he may what?
No.
He didn't want to listen to God. He don't want to listen to God. That's why we ignore a fool. We ignore a fool because a fool don't want to listen to God. Read it again.
That ye may know.
That ye may what?
No.
You may what?
No!
You don't know nothing. That's why you're
you
a fool.
Know,
again.
That's
right.
And
no!
You
have you may what?
No!
And you can't
course,
even
I don't know nothing. That's why I rely on God.
That's
you
right.
I do
that's
what God says. God says, don't eat bats. I ain't eating no bats. My household don't got coronavirus.
That's why you
but you Chinese, you've been eating bats since 300, 400, 1,000 years ago.
Right.
And you're full of coronavirus. I obey God. I obey God. I obey God.
That's right.
God said, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians are his chosen. Read.
That ye may know how that the Lord doeth put a different, a different, a different, a different between Egyptians and Israel.
God puts a difference between Egyptians and Israel. Them Africans ain't no damn Israelites.
That's right.
And that's why they got coronavirus. That's why they got Ebola.
That's right.
That's why they got the plagues of God.
Weak-ass topic for today, Corona.
No.
That's your weak-ass
no,
topic.
No, you my weak-ass
topic.
That's
your weak-ass topic. Right.
You are my weak-ass topic.
Right.
You are my weak-ass topic.
Come on, man.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians are God's children. God is putting
prove
a difference
prove
between the
prove
Egyptians
prove
and the Hebrews.
That's
just
it.
Like he's doing
prove
now with the coronavirus. The coronavirus ain't
show
touching us,
me a
but it's
Bible
touching them. The coronavirus
show
ain't touching the Hispanics, but it's
chart
touching them.
Show
the coronavirus ain't
this
touching the Native but Indians,
but
it's touching them.
Y'all don't,
you
cause y'all need some help with the
listen,
white man.
You, all you want to do is be on camera. You just want to be on camera and love Africans because you're filthy, disgusting, heathen worshiping niggas. You're heathen worshiping niggas.
Nothing like us. They don't look nothing like us.
So what? So wait. Hold on.
You got to,
so it's by looks? Is it by looks?
Absolutely.
You are racist like
the
white man.
The phenotype of the black man is
it has nothing to do with looks.
Right. I see you
it
as
has
a black
nothing
man
to do with
Hebrew
looks. It has nothing to do
yes,
with
it
looks.
Does, you right dumbass.
Is Bob, does Bob Marley look like you? Does Bob Marley look like you?
Come on. Come on.
Right.
Bob Marley the white father.
Does Bob Marley,
Bob Marley
look like you?
Father.
I didn't ask you that. I didn't
he
ask you that.
Right.
But I didn't ask you that.
Right.
Does Bob Marley look like you?
Yes.
So he has the, what's the funny word?
The phenotype.
Because
our gene is dominant.
So he got the phenotype
because
like you.
Gene is dominant.
So he got the phenotype like you.
He's Israelite-ish.
He's Israelite-ish.
Yes, that's a scriptural
but
word.
But he looks like you.
That's a scriptural word.
But he looks
what
like you.
That's in the Bible.
But he looks like you. Don't laugh at him. He getting sensitive.
No, no, because
he
that's
getting
the Bible.
Sensitive.
He just showed his ignorance. How do you say he showed his ignorance? What did he laugh at? Because that's in the Bible.
That's
Israelite
looks,
Israelite
looks
is
like
a term
you
in the Bible.
But he looks like you. So does that make him an Israelite?
He's not an Israelite because his father's white.
So if his father was
Israelite
black. If his father was black.
Because our genes are dominant. Now how did the
okay,
Mexicans
if our,
get
wait,
like
hold
that?
On. If
from,
our
from
genes
their father
are dominant,
or from their mother.
If our genes
God
are dominant.
That they were raped, but ain't that the seed of the
genes
father?
Are dominant.
If they were raped and that's why they look like that, ain't that the seed of the father?
This nigga gave me coronavirus.
Yeah,
I
right, right?
If our genes are dominant,
yeah.
Do you know of that basketball player named Blake Griffin?
Yeah.
What does he look like?
He looks like a light-skinned black.
He looks like a beach boy. Right. He looks like a white man.
Right. He looks like a light-skinned black.
No, he looks like a white man.
Right. Right.
Mariah Carey, does she look black?
I don't know her. I don't know her race.
She's black.
I don't know. Is her father black?
Yes. Her father's black, her mother's white.
All
right,
so she's,
yeah. Your argument goes out the window.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't matter what you look like.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't.
The phenotype makes a big difference.
It doesn't matter. It's about the blood. It's about the bloodline.
That's right.
It's about a bloodline. It's about what does blood look like?
How did they look?
What does blood look like?
How did they get their appearance?
What does blood look like? It has nothing to do with the appearance.
How did they get their appearance?
It has to do with the bloodline.
Right.
It has to do with the bloodline. You saying Bob Marley genes dominant? But Marley's son looked like an Ethiopian.
Right.
So what is he really?
Right.
That little Damian Marley, he don't look like none of the other brothers. Why? Why?
If he had a black mother, then he's Israelite.
If he has a black mother?
If he has a black mother.
Then he's Israelite, and that's Bob Marley's son?
Yes.
So Bob Marley is not an Israelite.
He was Israelite-ish.
But he's not an Israelite, but his son is an Israelite? You a fool.
I didn't learn foolology.
So Mugabe. Mugabe, and what's the other one? Idi Amin.
They look just like you.
Is Idi Amin your brother? Idi Amin look just like Marcus Garvey. Who's an Israelite and who's an African?
What?
See?
I don't understand
you. The scriptures say ignore a fool. And I'm stupid, but I ain't listening. Idi Amin looked just like Marcus Garvey.
Right.
Who is the Israelite and who is the African?
Who's me?
Looking for a wife.
Yeah,
you want to answer her question.
Ham and Shem.
Who is the Israelite and who is the African?
No, Ham and Shem are both black.
Marcus Garvey.
J-Fair.
And Idi Amin. See where he going?
Yeah,
you can't answer because you're a fool.
That's not
get a cap of hand, man.
That's not even
get a cap of hand for exposing what it is,
that's
man.
That's not a question.